Hello students, let's see the introduction to the chapter similar triangles. Before that, let's recall the concept of congruency in triangles which we have studied last year. We know that two triangles are congruent to each other if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are also equal. In simple words, when two triangles are identical in every aspect, one triangle looks just like the other, then the two triangles are said to be congruent to each other. When you superimpose such triangles, that is when you place one triangle over the other, you will see that the vertices coincide. We've also seen the five congruence criteria which help us to prove that two triangles are congruent. What are they? SSS, SAS, AAS, ASA, and RHS. These are the five congruence criteria. Now let's understand what we mean by similar figures. Look at the two circles here. The inner circle has a smaller radius when compared to the outer circle. Clearly, the two circles are not congruent to each other. They're not congruent. They're not identical. This is small. This is big. These two circles have different radii, so they are not congruent, but they are said to be similar to each other. Because the outer circle is a magnified version of the inner circle. The outer circle is a magnified version of the inner circle. Two circles with the same radius are said to be congruent. When two circles have different radius, they are similar to each other. Apply the same thing here. The square. Now, what you see here is a square. This is a small square. Outside here, we see a bigger square. So maybe the side of the square is 2 centimeters and the side of the square says 4 centimeters. Now, these two squares are not congruent to each other because they're not identical. They're not identical. They're not equal in every aspect. Their angles may be equal because in a square, each angle is equal to 90 degrees. Their angles may be equal, but their sides are not equal. So these two squares are not congruent to each other, but they are similar to each other because the outer square is a magnified version of the inner square. Or you can say that the inner square is a diminished version of the outer square. The inner square is a diminished version of the outer square. So these two squares are said to be similar to each other. They are not congruent. They're not congruent because they're not identical, but they are similar to each other because, as we understood, the outer square is a magnified version of the inner square, or the inner square is a diminished version of the outer square. Similarly here, these two squares, they're not congruent to each other. When you place the square over this, the vertices will not coincide. When you place the square over this one, the vertices will not coincide. So these two squares are not congruent to each other, but they are similar to one another. They are similar to each other. Look at these triangles. They are equilateral triangles. These triangles are equilateral triangles. Now, when you look at these two triangles, they're not congruent to each other. Because even if their angles are equal, their sides are not equal. As in the case of the squares. The angles may be equal, but their sides are not equal. So these two squares are not congruent to each other, but they are similar to each other. So here also in these equilateral triangles, each angle in both the triangles is equal to 60 degrees. Their angles are equal, but their sides are not equal. So they are not congruent to each other. But the two triangles, the two equilateral triangles are similar to one another. Here also, these two equilateral triangles are similar to one another. Now look at these two quadrilaterals, quadrilateral ABCD and quadrilateral PQRS. Look at these two quadrilaterals. Now we cannot conclude anything about their angles. Like in the case of the squares or equilateral triangles, we know that in a square, each angle is 90 degrees. In an equilateral triangle, each angle is equal to 60 degrees. But when we consider these two quadrilaterals, we are not sure about the measure of angle A, measure of angle B, measure of angle C, measure of angle D. We are not sure about the measures of the angles of this quadrilateral. So as in the case of the quadrilateral PQRS, we cannot say anything about the angles in PQRS. So nothing can be concluded about the angles. We know nothing about their sides. Now in this case, it's difficult to say that the two quadrilaterals are similar to each other. Why was it easy to say here? Because since the angles are equal, when you magnify this triangle, you can see this triangle. This triangle is a magnified version of this triangle. But you're not sure if you magnify this, if it will look like this, or if you diminish this in size, if that would look like this. Because you're not sure about the angles. We are not sure about the angles of quadrilateral ABCD. Nor are we sure about the angles of quadrilateral PQRS. So, like we could say that these circles are similar to each other, the squares are similar to each other, equilateral triangles are similar to each other, we cannot conclude that these two quadrilaterals are similar to each other. Then, what is the condition for similarity? When are two figures said to be similar? So two figures are said to be similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are proportional. Now when we say two figures, let's say two polygons, and they must be polygons of the same number of sides. All right. They must be polygons of the same number of sides. we cannot establish similarity or congruency between a pentagon and a hexagon, because the two figures are entirely different. A pentagon and a hexagon are entirely different figures. So we cannot establish congruency or similarity between these two figures. So like congruency, similarity can also be established between two polygons with the same number of sides. That is, we can say that two triangles are congruent or similar to each other. Two quadrilaterals are congruent or similar to each other. Two pentagons are congruent or similar to each other. Basically, the two figures must have the same, the two polygons must have the same number of sides. So two polygons with the same number of sides are said to be similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are proportional. And their corresponding sides are proportional. Have a look at the pictures, the photographs of Taj Mahal here. You can see that the pillar here is at right angle to the ground. The pillar here in this photograph is also at right angle to the ground. And the pillar here is also at right angle to the ground. So in all the three figures, the angle which the pillar makes with the ground is the same. Now, when you measure the angles at different points, you will see that the angles in these three different figures will be the same everywhere. Then this photograph is bigger than this, and this is bigger than this. Then what changes? What changes? The lens of the line segments, or in the case of the Taj Mahal, the dome is a hemisphere. In the case of the Taj Mahal, the dome is a hemisphere. Correct? So the radius of the hemisphere. So what changes is the length of the line segments and the radius of the hemisphere here. So when you compare these two photographs, the height of the pillar here is proportionately smaller when compared to this. The radius of the hemisphere here is smaller than the radius of the hemisphere here. So the height of this pillar is less than the height of this pillar. The radius of this hemisphere here is less than the radius of the hemisphere here. When you compare these two photographs further, the height of the pillar here is smaller than the height of the pillar here. The radius of the hemisphere here is smaller than the radius of the hemisphere here. So we see that when these three photographs are of different sizes, the angles at different points remain the same. It's the length of the line segments that differ, or the radius of the circular portions that differ. Circular or hemispherical or spherical figures. All right, it is the length of the line segments or the radius of any portion which is circular or hemispherical or spherical that changes. So we say that these two photographs are similar to each other. These two photographs are similar to each other, or these are similar photographs. These are similar photographs of Taj Mahal. These are similar photographs of Taj Mahal. Because everywhere the angles are the same. It's just that the length of the line segments that increase or decrease. Look at the experiment here. Let's understand what this experiment is about. This also emphasizes that in two similar figures, see, when we say figures, two polygons with the same number of sides. Two polygons with the same number of sides. We understood that congruency and similarity cannot be established between two polygons with different number of sides. All right. What is this experiment about? This experiment is again to understand that in two similar figures, the angles are not altered. The angles remain the same. It's the length of the line segments that vary. All right. Now, here you see a bulb which is positioned at this point O. A bulb that's positioned at the point O. The mother and daughter are holding a quadrilateral ABCD. Now, say this is the table. This is a table. Now, they are holding the quadrilateral parallel to the surface of the table. They are holding the quadrilateral parallel to the surface of the table below the bulb. Now, when the bulb glows, the rays from the bulb, they hit the surface of the quadrilateral. And say this quadrilateral is made of cardboard. This quadrilateral is made of cardboard. All right. So when the rays of the rays from the bulb hit the cardboard, we know that light travels in a straight line. Light travels in a straight line. So when the light hits the edges of the cardboard, light cannot pass through the cardboard because it's opaque. It cannot pass through it. But when it hits the boundary of the quadrilateral, you can see the reflection formed on the surface of the table. Now, as we understood that light travels in a straight line, you will see that the vertex A dash, now the new quadrilateral formed is A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. You will see that the point A dash lies on the ray OA. The point B dash lies on the ray OB. The vertex or the point C dash lies on the ray OC. See here, this is the quadrilateral ABCD inside here, ABCD. Okay, see the ray OC here like this. This is the ray OC. You will see that the vertex or the point C dash lies on the ray OC. And the vertex or the point D dash here lies on the ray OD. You can see the four rays in dotted lines. You can see it here. Ray OA and A dash lying on OA. Ray OB, this is the vertex B. Ray OB, and B dash lying on OB. You can see the ray OC here. Ray OC and C dash will lie on OC. Ray OC. And you can see the ray OD here. OD. And D dash lying on the ray OD. Now when you measure the angles of quadrilateral ABCD and the quadrilateral A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, these are the conclusions. you will see that angle A is equal to angle A dash. Angle B is equal to angle B dash. Angle C is equal to angle C dash. And angle D is equal to angle D dash. You will see that the corresponding angles are equal. You will see that the corresponding angles are equal. When you actually measure the angles, when you actually measure the angles of the two quadrilaterals, you will see that their corresponding angles are equal. And you will also see that their corresponding sides are proportional. Say, by actually measuring, when you actually measure the length of the side AB, say it is 4 centimeters. You measure the length of the side A dash B dash, say it is 6 centimeters. So the ratio is, the ratio AB by A dash B dash is 4/6, which is 2/3. You will see that the ratio BC by B dash C dash will also be 2/3. See, BC need not measure 4 centimeters. BC may be something like 2 centimeters, then B dash C dash will be 3 centimeters. The ratio will be 2/3. CD say is 8 centimeters. Just for example, CD, if CD measures 8 centimeters, you will see that C dash D dash will measure 12 centimeters. 8/12, 2/3. The ratio will be the same everywhere. The ratio will be the same everywhere. Again, when you measure AD and when you measure A dash D dash, you will see that the ratio AD by A dash D dash will also be 2/3. The length of AD, say if the length of AD is 5 centimeters, if the length of AD is 5 centimeters, then the length of A dash D dash will be 7.5 centimeters. Will be 7.5 centimeters. 5/7.5, 2/3. The ratio will be 2/3 everywhere. The lengths will be different. But the ratio, when you find the ratio on the corresponding sides, when we say corresponding sides, AB corresponds to A dash B dash, BC corresponds to B dash C dash, CD corresponds to C dash D dash, and AD corresponds to A dash D dash. When you find the ratio of the corresponding sides, you will see that the ratio is 2/3 everywhere. So this proves that in two similar quadrilaterals, their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are proportional. Their corresponding sides need not be equal. Their corresponding sides are proportional. When two quadrilaterals are congruent, when two quadrilaterals are congruent, their corresponding angles will be equal and their corresponding sides also will be equal. When two quadrilaterals are congruent. Now here, in two similar quadrilaterals, their corresponding angles will be equal. The angles will be equal. Their corresponding sides and their corresponding sides will be proportional. So, in both congruency and similarity, the corresponding angles are equal. In congruent triangles or in congruent quadrilaterals, the corresponding sides will also be equal. But here, in similar quadrilaterals, their corresponding sides will be proportional. So in both similarity and congruency, angles are equal. In congruency, sides are also equal. In similarity, the sides are proportional. The corresponding sides are proportional. So this is what we understood. two polygons of the same number of sides are similar if all the corresponding ANDs are equal and all the AND, see that AND, both the conditions must be satisfied. It's not any one of the two. Both of them should be satisfied. All the corresponding angles are equal and all the corresponding sides are proportional or in the same ratio. All the corresponding angles will be equal. Angle A will be equal to angle A dash. Angle B will be equal to B dash. Angle C will be equal to angle C dash. Angle D will be equal to angle D dash. All the corresponding angles will be equal. And all the corresponding sides will be proportional. So in this case, in our example, the ratio was 2/3 everywhere. It will be, when you actually measure and check, the ratio will be a constant. The ratio of the corresponding sides, the ratio of all the corresponding sides will be the same. So we say that quadrilateral ABCD is similar to quadrilateral A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. This is the essence of similarity. This is the essence of similarity. Corresponding angles equal, corresponding sides proportional. That is, the corresponding sides, all the corresponding sides have the same ratio. Have a look at these two quadrilaterals. So here we have quadrilateral ABCD. Here quadrilateral PQRS. What do we observe? What do we observe? Angle A is equal to angle P, equal to 105 degrees. Angle B is equal to angle Q, is equal to 100 degrees. Angle C is equal to angle R, equal to 70 degrees. Angle D is equal to angle S, equal to 85 degrees. So vertex A corresponds to vertex P. Vertex B corresponds to Q. Vertex C corresponds to R. Vertex D corresponds to S. Corresponding angles are equal. What about the sides? AB is one point. So if A corresponds to P and B corresponds to Q, then AB corresponds to PQ. Because A corresponds to P, B corresponds to Q, then AB corresponds to PQ. So what is AB by PQ? 1.5/3. That is equal to 1/2. The ratio is 1/2. Now the side BC corresponds to QR. What's the ratio BC by QR? 2.5/5, which is again 1/2. The side CD corresponds to the side RS. So CD by RS is equal to 2.4/4.8, which is 1/2. And finally, the side DA corresponds to the side SP. So DA by SP, the ratio DA by SP is equal to 2.1/4.2. which is again 1/2. So we see that all the corresponding sides have the same ratio. All the corresponding sides have the same ratio. That is, the corresponding sides are in proportion. They are proportional. So in quadrilateral ABCD and in quadrilateral PQRS, see, note this, both are quadrilaterals. These are two polygons with the same number of sides. That is why we are studying congruency or similarity. If they had different number of sides, straight away you can say that they are neither congruent nor similar. In fact, those terms are not applied to two figures with different number of sides. So coming back to ABCD and PQRS, in ABCD and PQRS, all the corresponding angles are equal and all the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is similar to quadrilateral PQRS because corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are in the same ratio. So ABCD is similar to PQRS. Let's see some more examples. Let's see if what the emphasis is, that it is not any one of the two. Corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are proportional. Only when both exist, we say that the quadrilaterals here are similar to each other. Now here we have a square ABCD and a rectangle PQRS. Now in the square and rectangle, all their angles are equal. So you can say that A corresponds to P, B corresponds to Q, C corresponds to R, and D corresponds to S. But what about the ratio of the corresponding sides? AB by PQ, 3 by 3.5, which is equal to 6 by 7. The ratio is 6 by 7. BC by QR, 3 by 3, 1. But the ratio here, AB by PQ is 6 by 7. Here, BC by QR is 1. The ratios are different. The ratio AB by PQ is not equal to the ratio BC by QR. So the square ABCD and the rectangle PQRS are not similar to each other. Their corresponding angles are equal, but their sides, their corresponding sides are not proportional. Therefore, they are not similar. In general, a square and a rectangle are not similar to each other. But here, one of the two is satisfied. That is, the corresponding angles are equal. That is satisfied. But the corresponding sides are not proportional. So since both the conditions are not satisfied, they are not similar. The square and the rectangle, they are not similar. What do we have here? Here we have a square and a rhombus. We have a square and a rhombus. Here we have a square and a rhombus. In a square, every corner is a right angle. While in a rhombus, all the angles are not equal to 90 degrees. In a rhombus, angles are not equal to 90 degrees. In a square, each angle is equal to 90 degrees. So the corresponding angles are not equal. What about the sides? AB by PQ, 2.1 by 4.2, 1 by 2 is the ratio. BC by QR, same thing, 2.1 by 4.2, 1 by 2 is the ratio. The same thing everywhere. CD by RS is also 1 by 2. CD by RS is 1 by 2. And DA by SP is again 2.1 by 4.2, which is 1 by 2. So the ratio of the corresponding sides, the ratio of the corresponding sides is 1 by 2. But are the corresponding angles equal? No. The corresponding angles are not equal. But their corresponding sides are proportional. Sides are proportional. Angles are not equal. One is satisfied. One of the conditions is satisfied. The sides are proportional. But the other one, angles equal? No, that is not satisfied. So again, a square and a rhombus are not similar to each other. They are also not congruent to each other. They are not similar to each other because their sides may be proportional. The ratio on their sides, their corresponding sides may be the same, but their corresponding angles are not equal. So a square and a rhombus are not similar to each other. The concept of similarity is clear. let's check if we have really understood by answering these. Fill in the blanks using the correct word given in the brackets. Okay. All circles are dash. All circles are dash. So we'll use both the words and see which makes the correct statement. All circles are congruent. No, all circles are not congruent. What if we have a circle with radius 4 centimeters and another circle with radius 10 centimeters? Are these two circles congruent to each other? No. One is small, the other is big. So they're not congruent. Congruency is identical. Both of them should be identical. When you place one over the other, the circumference must coincide. The circumferences of the two circles must coincide. So all circles are congruent is incorrect. All circles are similar, correct. All circles are similar. A circle with radius 4 centimeters is similar to a circle with radius 10 centimeters. So all circles are similar. Similar is the correct option, correct word. Next one, all squares are similar, congruent. So let's see, all squares are congruent. No, a square with side 2 centimeters is not congruent to a square with side 5 centimeters. 2 centimeters square is small, 5 centimeters square is big. They are not congruent. Are they similar? A square with side 2 centimeters, a square with side 2 centimeters, and a square with side 5 centimeters. Are they similar? Yes, they are similar. When you zoom or when you magnify the square with side 2 centimeters, at a point you will get a square of side 5 centimeters. So one is a magnified version of the other, or the smaller one is a diminished version of the larger one. So all squares are similar. All squares are not congruent. All squares are similar. All dash triangles are similar. All equilateral triangles are similar. All equilateral triangles are similar. Because in two equilateral triangles, all angles will be equal. Because in an equilateral triangle, each angle is equal to 60 degrees. And in two equilateral triangles, their sides will be proportional. Their sides will be proportional. Supposing one triangle, equilateral triangle, 2 centimeters. The other is 5 centimeters. So the ratio will be 2 by 5 everywhere. Because equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So 2 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 2 centimeter. The other triangle, 5, 5, 5. So 2 by 5, 2 by 5, 2 by 5 will be the ratio everywhere. So all equilateral triangles are similar. Two polygons of the same number of sides are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are proportional. So that's about fill in the blanks. See the next one. Give two different examples of pair of similar figures. So two different examples of pair of similar figures. So we can say that a circle of radius 3 centimeters is similar to another circle of radius 7 centimeters. A square of side 3 centimeters is similar to another square of side 9 centimeters. An equilateral triangle of side 4.5 centimeters is similar to another equilateral triangle of side 6 centimeters. So these are some examples of a pair of similar figures. Next one, non-similar figures. Exactly what we saw here. Non-similar figures, two different examples of pair of non-similar figures. So one thing you know is two figures with different number of sides are not similar to each other. You know that a hexagon and a nonagon, a hexagon and a nonagon are not similar to each other. A square and a rhombus, a square, you can see it here, a square and a rhombus, we just discussed, a square and a rhombus are not similar. Their corresponding sides are proportional, but their corresponding angles are not equal. So a square and a rhombus are non-similar figures. What did we see earlier? Here, a square and a rectangle, they are non-similar figures because their corresponding angles may be equal, but their corresponding sides are not proportional. So examples of non-similar figures, square and rectangle can be one example. Square and rhombus can be another example. See this one here. State whether the following quadrilaterals are similar or not. Okay, state whether these two quadrilaterals, PQRS and ABCD, are similar or not. What do we see? Here it is 1.5 centimeters everywhere. So we can say this is a rhombus PQRS and this is a square ABCD. Rhombus PQRS, square ABCD. Because all sides are equal. And corners are right angle. So this is a square. Okay. And in this figure, you're sure angle P is not 90. You know how a right angle should look like. So angle P is not 90, Q is not 90, R and S. Then each of these angles is not equal to 90 degrees. While in the square, each angle is equal to 90 degrees. So straight away, the angles of PQRS and angles of ABCD, they don't correspond to each other. Angle P does not correspond to angle A because they're not equal, the angles are not equal. Q doesn't correspond to B. The angles are not equal. So in these two figures, corresponding angles are not equal. But the corresponding sides are proportional. 1.5 by 3, the ratio is 1 by 2. 1.5 by 3, 1 by 2, 1.5 by 3, 1.5 by 3. So the ratio is 1 by 2 everywhere. So corresponding sides are proportional, but the corresponding angles are not equal. Therefore, the two figures, PQRS and ABCD, are not similar to each other. They are not similar because only one condition is satisfied. Corresponding sides, all the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Corresponding sides have the same ratio, but the corresponding angles are not equal. So the two quadrilaterals are not similar to each other. So see this, two triangles are similar. So when do we say that two triangles are similar? We've been talking about quadrilaterals. Now, when do we say that two triangles are similar? Two triangles are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Exactly what we saw for quadrilaterals. Same thing, two triangles are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are in the same ratio or their corresponding sides are in proportion. So like how we have congruence criteria. Why do we have congruence criteria? So that, you know, we can show that two triangles are congruent with fewer, with lesser information. You don't have to check to prove that two triangles are congruent. You don't have to check every aspect of the two triangles. Now, when you use the SSS congruence criterion, when you use the SSS congruence criterion in two triangles, if you see that the sides of one triangle are equal to the sides of the other triangle, you don't have to check for the angles. You don't have to check if the angles are equal. If the sides are equal, automatically the angles also will be equal. So by SSS congruence criterion, you say that the two triangles are congruent to each other. So basically, we have this, we have these congruence criteria or similarity criteria, so that we don't have to check every aspect of the two triangles. We just check what is needed by the criterion and say that the two triangles are similar to each other. You can see it again here, what we just saw in words here. You can see it represented symbolically. Triangle ABC, triangle DEF. So in triangle ABC and DEF, if angle A is equal to D, B is equal to E, C is equal to F, and the side AB by DE is equal to BC by EF, is equal to CA by DF. If the ratio of the corresponding sides is the same everywhere, then the two triangles are similar. So this is a congruence, a similarity criterion. Sorry, not a congruence, similarity criterion. See here, AAA or AAA, 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 angle, 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 similarity criterion. So when you use this criterion to show that the triangles are similar to each other, it is enough if you check for the angles. When you check the angles, when you check for the equality of the angles, the sides will automatically be proportional. This criterion says that when the angles in two triangles are equal, when the corresponding angles are equal, the corresponding sides will automatically be proportional. So we don't have to check for that. When the angles are equal, the sides are automatically proportional, and so the triangles are similar to each other. See here? If in two triangles, corresponding angles are equal, you'll have to check only this. You'll have to check if the corresponding angles are equal. If you find their corresponding angles equal, then automatically their corresponding sides are also in the same ratio, and hence the two triangles are similar. So in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, ignore this dotted line segment PQ. That's a construction for the proof. Ignore it for the time being. So in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, okay, if angle A is equal to angle D, and angle B is equal to angle E, and angle C is equal to angle F. See, one thing is, when angle A is equal to D and B is equal to E, automatically C will be equal to F. Okay, C will be equal to X, F, because supposing this angle is 50 degrees and this is 60. What is 50 plus 60? 110. So this will be 70. Here also it's 50. We said angle A is equal to D, so 50. And B is equal to A, 60. B is equal to E, 60. So here also 50 plus 60, 110. So this will be 70 degrees. So when two angles are equal, the third angles will automatically be equal. That is why this criterion is also called the AA, AAA or AA similarity criterion. Because when two angles, when angle A is equal to D and angle B is equal to angle E, automatically C will be equal to F. So in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if you know that angle A is equal to angle D and angle B is equal to angle E, and of course angle C will be equal to angle F, then by the AAA, AAA similarity criterion, the two triangles will be similar to each other. When you check AB by DE, it will be the same as BC by EF. It will be the same as AC by DF. That is the ratio. AB by DE will be equal to BC by EF, will be equal to AC by DF. So similarity criterion simplifies our job. You don't have to check for the proportionality of the sides. When angles are equal, automatically the sides will be proportional. So when you use the AAA condition or the AAA similarity criterion, you just have to write in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F. Therefore, by AAA similarity criterion, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. What we see here, we again have two triangles. Their angles are not known. Angles are not known. But you can see the length of the sides of ABC and DEF. So BC is 6 centimeters. EF is 9 centimeters. What is BC by EF? 6 by 9 or 2 by 3. What is AC by DF? 8 by 12 or 2 by 3. What is AB by DE? 3 by 4.5 or 2 by 3. So you can see that the ratio of the corresponding sides is the same everywhere. BC by EF is equal to AC by DF is equal to AB by DE is equal to 2 by 3 is equal to 2 by 3. All these three ratios are equal to 2 by 3. So by the SSS similarity criterion, when in two triangles, their corresponding sides are proportional, then their corresponding angles will be equal, and hence the triangles are similar. So this is the SSS similarity criterion. If in two triangles, sides of one triangle are proportional to the sides of the other triangle, then AB by DE, the ratio AB by DE is equal to the ratio BC by EF is equal to the ratio CA by EFD. So if the sides of one triangle are proportional to the sides of the other triangle, then their corresponding angles are equal. Then automatically their angles will be equal. So say you construct these two triangles. Okay. So say you construct these two triangles. You construct this triangle ABC. So you will draw the line segment BC equal to 6 centimeters first. Then with B as center and radius 3 centimeters, you'll draw an arc. Then with C as center and radius 8 centimeters, you'll cut the earlier arc. And then you'll join BA and CA to get this triangle. How will you construct this triangle? You'll draw the line segment EF. You'll draw the line segment EF equal to 9 centimeters. Then with E as center and radius 4.5 centimeters, you'll draw an arc. With F as center and radius 12 centimeters, you'll cut the earlier arc and you'll join ED and FD. All right. Now, how have we constructed these two triangles? We didn't take the help of the angles at all. We don't even know what the angles of the two triangles are. Okay. We constructed the two triangles with the help of the sides. Now, using a protractor, when you measure angle B and angle E, you will see that they have the same measure. Angle B, say like angle B is 100 degrees, angle E also will be 100. But we did not use 100 degrees while constructing. We only used the sides and we constructed the two triangles. When you measure angle B and angle E, if this is 100, this also will be 100. If supposing this is say 30 degrees, angle A is 30 degrees, D also will be 30 degrees. You measure with the protractor, whatever you get for angle A, you will get the same thing for angle D. So if this is 100 and this is 30, the remaining angle is 50. So angle C will measure 50 and F also will measure 50. But we did not make use of these angles to construct the triangle or to construct the triangles. That is what this similarity criterion says. If in two triangles, the sides of one triangle are proportional to the sides of the other triangles, then their corresponding angles are equal. Then their corresponding angles, they will be equal. And hence the two triangles are similar. So it is enough if you write the ratio of the corresponding sides. You don't have to check if their angles are equal. If you know that the sides are proportional, then you can say by the SSS similarity criterion, the two triangles are similar to each other. Here you can see the SAS similarity criterion. We have only these three in our syllabus. There's one more RHS, which is not a part of our syllabus, so we'll not see that. So this is the SAS, side angle side similarity criterion. What does it say? If one angle of a triangle is equal to one angle of the other triangle and the sides including these angles are proportional, then the two triangles are similar. You don't have to check for any other information. You don't have to check anything else. Simply, if one angle of one triangle is equal to one angle of the other triangle and the sides including these angles are proportional, then the triangles are similar. So here in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, ignore this dotted line segment PQ. That's for construction for the proof. Ignore that. Just see the triangle DEF and ABC. Supposing we know that angle A is equal to angle D. Okay. We know that A is equal to D. Then AB and AC are the sides containing angle A. And DE and DF are the sides containing angle D. A and D. We are talking about angles A and D. Supposing angle A is equal to angle D. AB and AC are the sides that include angle A. DE and DF are the sides that include angle D. So if angle A is equal to angle D and if AB by DE is equal to AC by DF, then triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. This is the symbol for congruence, similarity. You can see it here, an inverted S. Maybe it's not very clear. So like this. All right. An inverted S like this. You write S like this, right? So when you say this, this symbol stands for similarity. All right. So coming back to this, so supposing we'll say angle B is equal to angle E, angle B is equal to angle E. Okay, then which are the sides contain angle B? Which are the two sides that contain angle B? AB and BC. Which are the two sides that contain angle E? DE and EF. So in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, if angle B is equal to angle E and if AB by DE is equal to BC by EF, then the two triangles ABC and DEF are similar by the SAS similarity criterion. If one angle of a triangle is equal to one angle of the other triangle and the sides including these angles are proportional, then the two triangles are similar. So these are the three similarity criteria. AAA or AA similarity criterion, SSS similarity criterion, SAS similarity criterion. Criterion is singular. Criteria is plural. All right, children. I hope the introduction is clear. I'll be sharing some YouTube links explaining the problems in the exercise. All these examples and the exercise problems explained in the videos, I shall be sharing those links. So you will find the rest of the explanation in the videos. All right. Fine, children. Thank you so much.